Hello everyone, this is Merritt Trainboy speaking, and today I would like to show you something that I've been working on for like a year and a half, and that is a Gauge 1 model of Thomas the Tank Engine. Now, some of you on YouTube may not know that I was actually making a Gauge 1 Thomas model. Well, I've been posting pictures about that on my DeviantArt page, and I've been showing one picture at a time while I was making it. And after I have posted the one of the model completed, I have decided to make this video and show how I made it. So, without further ado, let's get started. The project began in April 2019 after I bought a big styrene sheet from Walmart. After measuring and cutting for the sides of the running board and buffer beams, I used some tape to secure everything in place while gluing them together. Using more styrene, I have covered up the entire footplate. This picture shows what the underneath of the footplate looks like before I cut any holes in it to provide clearance for the chassis and wheels. Again, using more of the styrene sheet, I've cut out the sides of Thomas's tanks, coal bunker, and cab. Both the tanks and coal bunker were glued onto the top of the footplate, and I even drew a line to make sure that everything is evenly spaced. Once that was in place, I marked out and cut holes on the top of Thomas's coal bunker and also for the windows of his cab. After that, they were glued onto the model. Now, just to so you know, some of the glue that I used for this project was Gorilla Glue, and some of the other glue was JB Weld. Although, during the middle of making this model, I decided to use JB Weld for the rest of it. Once the sides were installed, I've cut out more pieces for the front and back of the cab. I made sure they were even and cut holes for the windows. Also, I even traced over where the holes are and then drew around them for the outlining for the front windows, like what Thomas has. But they weren't to be glued on once there was paint applied. Once this was done, they were installed. By looking at this picture, Thomas is starting to take shape. Cutting out yet more styrene sheets, I've made a pair of Thomas's wheel arches. This was a test fit to see how they would look on the model, and I made sure they wouldn't be too big or too small. After they were test fitted, I've marked the areas of where they should go. I then added the weird neck thing for Thomas, which looks like his boiler support. Again, tape was used while gluing everything together. Later, once that was finished, a PVC pipe was cut and added for the boiler. And since it seems to show a hole at the other end of where the cab is, I covered that up. While I started out building the tanks, I used AA batteries to help keep the cab nice and straight. These batteries are what I used to help cut the circles of the front and back windows, and it worked well. A lot of tape was used while building the tanks. Sometime later, I have received these 3D print pieces I've bought off of Shapeways. They are only tested to see of how they would look. By looking at this picture, Thomas is starting to take even more shape. Although, despite the fact that I haven't yet got any wheels, I have cut out the holes of where they should go. By looking at the bottom, you can see how they were cut accordingly. And because that the third wheel is right under the cab, I covered up to make it look like the floor. Although I kinda covered up most of it. Sometime later in the mail, I have received a pair of buffers which I have ordered off a website called Walls, Zolls, Models, Industries. And these were the perfect size for gauge 1. After marking of where the buffers should be, holes were drilled into the buffer beams. I took extreme care while making these holes so that the buffers would fit perfectly. Not too big, not too small, just right. In the end result, they seemed to look pretty good, but they weren't to be glued down at this particular moment. Later, I have received a 3D print of Thomas's happy face from Shapeways. But when I test fitted on the model, I realized that the model is a little too big for it, so apparently this had forced me to change the boiler with the correct size. And believe me, it was really tricky. After the old PVC pipe was taken out and I test fitted with the new one, I checked to see what else has to be changed. And of course, the tanks needed to be rebuilt as well. After measuring and raising the new boiler and then rebuilding the tanks again, Thomas is once more taking shape. I even used putty to cover up the lining on the smoke box area. Of course, the sides of the cab windows were floppy, so I used toothpicks to keep them straight and still. I also made the cab roof using more polystyrene, and then did a test fit to see how it would look. Although this was done quite a few times, but we'll get to that later on. So, not only the main body shell was mostly finished, it was time to work on the chassis. With a bit of cutting and marking, the chassis was also made from polystyrene, just like the main body of Thomas. The wheels here in this case were helpful in measuring how long the chassis would be. After the chassis was built, the body shell was test fitted to see how it would look. Now you see, my Thomas is a non-runner. At first, I wanted it to be a runner, like I would have it be remote controlled, but that would be sort of challenging to do by adding gears and stuff, and I just don't know where to start. Now besides that, after the chassis was built, I even made sure that the wheels would run freely, because I wanted my model to have free wheels. The axles at first were made from chopsticks, but I used a different kind of material to keep the wheels in place. I even cut some slots into the chassis for the wheels to slide in freely. But I even used a bit of supports to keep them in place. After I feel like that the chassis is done, it was spray painted in black paint. Now back to the main body itself. It was given a little bit of Bondo to fill in the cracks and edges, and some putty was also used to fill in the rough sections. I also made a cab control base set in the cab, but it does lack any controls. Also for the inside of Thomas's coal bunker, I used more styrene to cover up since I didn't want to put in that much coal all the way down. After doing some measuring and cutting, I decided that the load of coal would be at this level. Later, a pair of coupling hooks arrived in the mail, and after making the square spaces and cutting holes in the buffer beams, front and back, they seemed to look pretty good. Again, it was a test fit. A while back, I made these pieces which were to go under Thomas's smoke box. And soon after, I have been putting Bondo all over the model. They were glued into place. Also, I even put the letters L and R so that I would know which one is for the left side and the right side. Using a piece of thin iron and a bit of styrene, I've made Thomas's lamp irons. And then they were painted black. And as always, these weren't to be glued in at this moment. I've added the water tank lids, which were made from pins that were cut and filed. And then I added the dome and the funnel. This was the biggest part that I wanted to do for this project, and I'm just glad I did it. Although they weren't easy to make, but it was worth it. The funnel was made from a pen with a bit of styrene all around the top, and the dome was made from a marker base with a metal ball cut in half. A lot of putty was used here to keep them all nice and still. From the look of this picture, we can see that Thomas is truly taking shape, and this is where he was starting to look more recognizable. Next, after a bit of more putty, he was primered a bit, and then he was sanded. This was like probably the fifth time that I sanded him all over. And oh yes, of course, I can't forget about his wheel arches. They were placed with putty and then sanded as well. Using the same iron for the lamp irons, I even used them to place on the back for the rear cab windows. Because, you know, in case if any coal falls into the cab. Then Thomas was sanded all over again. And then he was primered again. And after it was all dry, he was spray painted in a nice coat of, you guessed it, blue paint. After the paint was dry, and after doing some masking, I have spray painted the foot plate in white. And after that, the sides of the running board was spray painted red and the smoke box black. Now, masking for me was really tedious to do, because in some areas have bleed through the tape, which I didn't want the paint to be on those particular areas, and it wasn't really great in the end result. This had forced me to redo the whole thing, and some masking spots were kind of a mess to try and get them perfect. But either that, the whole model started to look very nice. Also, the wheel arches were painted as well. I even made some little details for Thomas's cab, since I want my model to have a bit of details in it. So I painted the cab floor black and the control space gray, and then I installed that area of where the coal would come out from the coal bunker. I then added the little gauges at the front, and I even drew a little bit of gold lining to look like pipes that the gauges are connected to. The circle window frames, which I've explained about earlier, have been painted and finally have been added to the model. Next came pinstriping. The pinstriping was not really the best thing to work with, and it was kind of tedious. And it was tricky to get a curve on the wheel arches, and they weren't so perfect as I wanted them to be. Now, as you may know, Thomas's rear end has changed over the years. Since I decided to have my model to have that square lining at the back, since it was first seen from season 1. After a spray of clear coat, the number 1 decal was applied. Now here we can see that Thomas is definitely starting to look more recognizable. The sides of the cab windows were painted, which I kind of forgot about, and the cab doors were added along with the cab footsteps. And of course, these 3D prints were painted as well. I used clear plastic to represent glass for the front cab windows, and they were glued in the back. And finally, after it was painted, the cab roof was added. rubber bands was used to help hold the roof down while gluing. And after the glue was dry, the roof looks pretty nice. Although this was kind of done like a few times to see which roof would be the best for the model. And after the perfect one was added, Thomas looks basically finished. But of course, a few more details are missing. The buffers and coupling hooks were painted and installed, along with the lamp and lamp irons. Although there was absolutely no way I would be able to make Thomas's whistle from scratch, so I made it on my 3D printer, along with a few other pieces for the wheels. I made a few sizes of it to see which one would be the best, and after I found the correct size, it was painted and then glued into place, and it looks pretty good. And of course, I even added Thomas's rear lamp at the back. And some black fish tank pebbles was placed into the coal bunker to represent coal. Thomas's brake pipes were made from a piece of bending wire with a bit of clay, and after they were painted, they were added onto the model both front and back. After the wheels and coupling rods were painted, I had finally finished building the entire chassis. But although I had to do a little bit of rebuild to it, because the track I had used for the base was actually made by Lionel, and it was apparently a bit larger than the regular large-scale track that you would find on a garden railroad. So I had to shorten the axles so that the wheels can fit onto this style of track perfectly. And once that was done and the chassis was complete, the body shell was placed onto it. Thomas's face was painted in a nice clear of gray, and then the eyebrows were added and some white in his mouth to look like teeth. And then the eyeballs were added. The eyeballs were made from shank buttons with black dots done with a Sharpie. And once the face was complete, it was added onto the model with the help of blue tack. And then, after all that hard work... my Gauge 1 Thomas the Tank Engine model is done. After a year and a half of hard work, sweat, and all that concentration for some time, I had finally finished this project. Part of me thought that I would never get this model completed, but that part was wrong, and I made sure it was. And I certainly have come a long way since I started making him. Also, if you look at some areas around the model, you will notice that they don't make the whole train here look exactly of what the real Thomas from the TV show looks like. That's why this model isn't supposed to look television identical, just television accurate. The reason why I decided to make this model in the first place is because I wanted to be reminded of the Thomas that I grew up with. The Thomas that I've known so much as a child. And here he does have his flaws of what he actually looks. I had planned to not rest after this model has everything that I wanted it to be. And of course, I successfully did that. Not only that this was the most biggest project that I have ever done in my life, but this was also the big budgeted project that I have ever done. I am so glad that I have made this model, and I think this would be a perfect tribute to the 75th anniversary. If you enjoyed this video on how I made this Gauge 1 Thomas model, make sure you like it. And if you would like to see some more project videos like this in particular, make sure you let me know in the comments. So until next time, thanks for watching, everyone. This is Merritt Trainboy signing off.